Hey you guys, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton in San Antonio, Texas at WebTegrity, and you know if you watch my channel, I normally speak about everything to do with WordPress, whether that's how to optimize your website for better ranking or best practices inside of the WordPress world, whatever that looks like. But this week, I want to show you a tip that maybe if you're a freelancer or you're a subcontractor or you're even a small agency and you're trying to figure out how to improve your process when it comes to linking a Google Sheet to a Google Doc. I use it for my contracts. So it's really difficult sometimes to have a calculator out available to try to do all your math and then make sure it looks really nice for the client. You're going to double check your math. Ugh, it gets frustrating and it gets time consuming. So I've been trying to figure out how do you link a Google Sheet to a Google Doc, because if inside Google Sheets, you can run your calculations. But I want it to look really nice and I want to be able to save it as a PDF and export it with our logo and everything. So here's what I've figured out. Ready for this? It's going to be really cool. So I've got this right here where this is going to be our contract that goes to the client, right? But I want to add in kind of the detailed task and the rate and the cost. So I want to build a table here of kind of an overview of what's included in this scope of work. So I've created a Google Sheet that has the service, the rate, the hours, and the fee. And I've done simple math in here where I want to multiply $85 an hour times 6 hours, and this is the dollar amount. The way you do that inside of Google Sheets is just by using some of the commands. So this would be product, so you multiply it, and you would highlight the fields you want to multiply, and that would give you that calculation there. So it's really cool. Each one of these things kind of has that playing across in the row. And then down this column, I do the simple math, add these together, multiply it times our Texas sales tax rate, and then there's the total project cost. Now I want to take this table out dynamically and have it live inside of a Google Doc and still look really nice and slick. Check this out. So I'm just going to highlight every field that I want to bring over and I want to link from my Google Sheet to my Google Doc. I'm gonna highlight those fields and I'm gonna click copy, or you can easily go up to edit and click copy. Then you're gonna go over to your Google Doc. Now this is where the trick came, that I was racking my head trying to figure this out and I ended up trying to find an app to do it. It doesn't work if you just click Control V or if you click paste. It does not work. You have to right mouse click here or go up to edit and click paste. Look at this cool little window that pops up. This links to the spreadsheet. So you're going to choose that option, click paste, and now this is now linked to that. See this little icon? It's linked to that sheet. So any changes I make in that sheet will reflect over here. I'm going to change this just a little bit to kind of fit my layout here on this page just a little bit more. I'm going to even change the table properties to look a little nicer and cleaner. Okay, so that's kind of how I want this to look. Now let's say I'm done and I can export this as a PDF. You're off and running. But I'm going to show you something really cool. Notice that I have 6 hours here for design and 3 hours for SEO. Let's say the client wanted to expand the scope and wanted to say, I want more. You can come over here and change that to 10 hours and say we're going to do 8 hours for SEO. And notice that all my calculations are automatically happening. All my math is being done for me. Once that's finished, I can come over here back to my Google Doc and look at this. It says update. It knows I've made changes over there. So if I click update, it's gonna go grab my figures again. There's my 10, there's my 8 with all the correct calculations. Oh, that's so cool. If and when you're ready to be finished with this, you're ready to send it to the client, you can unlink this table now and go in and export it as a PDF and you're off and running. Oh, you guys, I hope that helps you, because it was kind of a crazy little question mark I had. Be sure to subscribe to our channel, because every week I'm creating some sort of a free video like this for you to watch inside the world of WordPress, the freelancers, and the subcontractor world. All right, have a great one, y'all. I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye.